Hey there, thank you for tuning in. My name is Mallory. My brand is When Mallory Lives, and today I'm going to be talking to you about a journey that I've been on for the past 31 days. What exactly am I talking about? I committed to eating a raw vegan diet for 30 days. Or 31 days, because October is 31 days. So 31 days, I have not eaten any cooked foods and minimally processed foods. If they were processed, they were processed by me. And I just wanted to share some pros and some cons of committing to this high raw journey. And I have to say high raw, I heard it from someone that was talking about their raw vegan journey and how they don't identify as a raw vegan. They just identify that they eat a high raw diet because they don't want to mislead people by thinking that they eat 100% raw vegan, which I actually committed to about 99% raw vegan. There were a couple of times where I had vegan mayo on like a chickpea something that I made. And then last night I made a no tuna salad, raw no tuna salad with chickpeas, and then I used some vegan mayo in it, which was not the bulk of it, it was just a few squeezes, but it was just enough for me to not say that this journey is 100% raw vegan for the last 31 days, but I did my best. I have prepared a list of pros and cons, just so that it's, I'm not misleading people to think that it was all good and everything was good. There were certainly some challenges that I came across, and I didn't even realize that it would be a challenge. A couple of things specifically that I wouldn't think be a challenge. So I'll start with the pros, because when somebody commits to something, they always want the positive result without necessarily wanting the negative results, although negative results come. I should start by saying also that I have been mostly plant-based for 5 years. So June 25th is my plant-based versary, and I completely went cold turkey on meat June 25th, 2016. I was 6 months breastfeeding my son. Through my pregnancy, I consumed a meat diet, dairy. I did all this stuff. And then I watched What the Health, and then I completely changed the trajectory. The dairy products and the animal products have been the most difficult to overcome, and I don't, I used to not make a big deal if there was eggs in something or butter in something, but my son has a food sensitivity to eggs. I forgot if it's the white part or the yolk part. It's one of the two. Anyway, I digress. The point is that before this month, I had cut everything. I was completely plant-based with the exception of I tried a crumble cookie because I just wanted a crumble cookie, and I probably could have got a vegan version of it if there's a vegan version of it. I didn't look at the menu. I just remember I like chocolate chip cookies. So I got it, and then I was like, oh, this probably wasn't all plant-based, but I didn't die. Look, I'm still alive. So it was fine. Anyway, pros. First of all, I am a person who has struggled with consistency in my whole entire life. Being consistent with things has not been my forte, but I certainly feel more confident and I feel powerful because I was consistent in this diet this month. And without an accountability, I had accountability partner, which he really, my partner, Raymond, wasn't really all that accountable to me. We just happened to be doing it together and sharing the same challenges. So that was important, but I was doing most of the work. I think he touched our juicer one time in the whole entire month. So I was doing all the work, all the preparation, and I was committing to it 100%. So I'm super proud of myself because with this challenge, I've overcome a journey that I didn't realize that I had. Secondly, as you can see, my skin is glowing. I have had pretty good skin. I'm thankful that I have not had, you know, the bouts of acne and things like that. But the acne was inside. I had PCOS, so that's a whole nother thing. But had PCOS, no longer have PCOS because plant-based diet. Thank you. But at any rate, my skin has always been clear, but now it's just glowing. When you skip the process of the fruits and vegetables and you go straight for the fruit and vegetable, they are giving you exactly what they're intended to do. So I'm proud of my skin. My skin is on glow. No filter needed. Another pro, my bloat disappeared. So this month when I started the diet, I was starting my period, and if you can attest to this, when you start your period, sometimes your stomach just pops out. It could be flat most of the month, and then it's like the uterus gets swollen. But I have not been bloated. In fact, my period came or started again, and I didn't even know it was coming. Like I say, during the plant-based diet, comparatively speaking, when I used to have super cramps when I was eating a meat diet and I was stuck to the couch for a few days because I couldn't stand up straight. So I went from that to, you know, feeling little cramps here and there, but this past 31 days and, you know, having another cycle again, I literally didn't know it was coming. In fact, I was completely surprised that it was coming, and it's super light. So not that I had heavy, heavy periods on a plant-based diet. They were lighter. But this period is light. I was wondering if I was even having a period, but now I have to go back and say, like, those were actually period days. So I feel like my thoughts have become more clear. I don't know. I guess I've never been in tune to that, but it just felt like the clog of my brain has been melting. And sometimes I have like brain glitches where my thoughts become a little bit jumbled and I forget what I'm doing. But overall, I feel like my thoughts have become more clear. And with that, I feel as though the conversations between my partner and I have been the most intimate, deep, vulnerable conversations that we've ever had in our whole entire 17-year relationship, just in this month, which is absolutely crazy. We've been having deep conversations because we've been practicing to be a little bit more emotionally mature, but now I feel like our conversations have amped up. And with that, my intuition, because I've, believe it or not, my Leo Sagittarius self has not been very intuitive in life. But I feel like my intuition is amping up just a little bit. So I'm pretty proud of that. I haven't got the best sleep this month, but I will say the sleep that I have gotten, I feel like even if I didn't get enough sleep, It was deep sleep. It was so deep of a sleep that it was refreshing. So, I didn't need the long sleep. And there was like a night where I only got 4 hours of sleep. And I was still fine. Like I didn't have to take a nap during the day and I was okay. Detox. So your body certainly does go through a detox. I didn't think I had anything to detox because, like I said, I've been eating a pretty clean diet, but years and years and years of eating a SAD diet is what they call it, a standard American diet, does wreak havoc to your body. And so I know now that there are other things that I need to detox out of my body. It's like day three or four, I use natural deodorant, and because I don't eat meat, my natural deodorant has actually worked for me. But then, like day three or day four, I started to realize that it was me that was stinking. I was like, what is going on? So I say all that to say that your body does go through a detox, and so I guess that can go into the cons. In turn, when your body is detoxing, it's doing a lot to process all those toxins out. So then you do feel a lack of energy. And it wasn't because I was hungry. I haven't been hungry this whole entire time. I've been fully satiated. The fruits and vegetables, there's abundance of many different things that you can combine to make different tastes and seasonings. Like it's actually the other diet is more restrictive than the high raw diet because you don't have as much a selection. So the cooked foods and stuff like that, you actually it's a smaller, it's like raw vegan and then or you know the raw diet and then cooked foods and then meat-based diet. The meat-based diet is the most restrictive in my experience. So not just in my opinion, but my experience has been most restrictive. And so it's not that at all. I've been eating very well. It's just that I know that my body's going through the detox. So I've only worked out twice. I did yoga one day and then I did a 3.15 mile walk slash run, and that was after I'm not getting enough sleep. So to the cons, I did talk about the detox and the lack of energy that you can have from the detox, not to be confused with hunger, because there's, like I said, I have absolutely no reason to be hungry. I have abundance of fruits and vegetables to eat. And so that is a con, not the number one con. I'll tell you about my number one con, but that was certainly a con. My first blog that I did was called Starting Is Difficult, and I will say that starting this diet was difficult. Diet is my understanding of the word diet, and our societal understanding of the word diet is not really what it is. Diet is just what you eat. And so the type of foods that you eat. And so I will say that this diet, this particular way of eating, can be difficult to get into because it's a learning curve. You have to spend a lot of time, as well, I feel like right now in my adult life, I've spent a lot of time unlearning things that I was learned or I learned from people around me or just experiences. And yeah, so one of the things that I'm unlearning about myself are limiting beliefs about myself. Like me saying that I'm inconsistent is a limiting belief about myself because it's actually a choice that I'm being inconsistent. Like what can I do to change that? And so that's why my first blog post was just start. All you gotta do is just start. You'll never know where it could take you. So I'm super proud of myself. I will say a con to this diet. I have a list. I have a list over here. I will say another con to this diet is that I feel like it's a luxury diet. So We do Instacart. We Instacart through Costco. We Instacart through Sprouts, and so our grocery bill has always been hefty, because, well, Sprouts in the processed section's always high. It seems like vegan food is incredibly expensive. Why would anybody want to be a vegan when they see like three burgers for $10? Like, that's not gonna feed a whole family. And the well, maybe now, because meat ridiculous, but that's another video for another day. But luxury diet, or certainly a luxury diet, because I don't feel like our grocery bill is reduced. I feel like we're still spending the same amount of money that we spent when we were buying foods to cook. And so, and then with that, it's because you're eating raw vegan. Mocha, get down. There she is being bad. Get down, Mo. Then with raw vegan, the food perishes quicker. So you can't just be like, oh, I'm gonna put it in the freezer and then cook it when I wanna cook it. Like, no, you gotta eat it now. And for a person like me who has always, not always fasted, but as I've gotten older, like I don't eat that much anyway. Like I get full fast. And with this diet, you get incredibly full fast, and so you can't eat through all the food. Like, I got two pineapples sitting over here that I gotta cut within 2 days, and I will cut them because I'll probably just juice them. Which brings me to my next point of preparation. Everything is from scratch, and so this diet I feel has been easier now that I am at home. And I am not having to do a 9 to 5 every day. So I think if I wasn't at home and been able to prepare my foods every day, then I would certainly not be successful with this diet. Me, not the general population. This is my experience. Me, as a person who's not a morning person, does not like to wake up early, who is late to everything, I just would not be successful on this diet if I had to also prepare things to go to work and then work all day and then come home and be tired and then have to prepare everything from scratch, wash all the vegetables, wash all the fruits, cut them up, put them in the juicer, separate them out, do the dishes after you wash all the vegetables, which my kitchen counter has turned into. There's so many things. We have the Nama juicer, we have the food processor, which I've used a whole ton. We have the Vitamix, which I use. There's all the parts to the juicer. There's like six parts. It's easy to do. It's easy to clean, but it's just time consuming because you have to make sure that all the vegetable pieces, all the fruit pieces are taken out. So, yeah, certainly that is the journey. And my number one con to this whole diet, the high raw vegan diet, is that it's a cold diet. So, being raw means that you cannot, even if you use a dehydrator, have your food over 115 degrees. Like, it can dry out, but it can't be cooked over 115 degrees, which is not cooked. To be cooked, it has to be over 115 degrees. I guess it depends on who you talk to too, because some of my YouTube friends, that ain't my friends in real life, but they my friends because they helped me through this without them knowing. They have said 118 or something. So it's 115, 118 to somewhere in there. So with that, I feel like every meal I consume is in front of the heater. I'm a naturally cold person. I'm in Kansas City, Missouri. This is not my climate. I need to be, and I'm working to get to somewhere tropical because this is not the place for me. It is too cold here. I do plan to continue this diet, or this way of living, for some time because I'm feeling great. I feel the best I felt in my whole entire life. It was not about weight loss for me, because with my running, I lost weight just fine, but all my clothes are loose. I guess that's a pro. All my clothes are loose, and so now I have to get clothes or find clothes that are fashionable, and for a person who likes to dress up and gets fancy, like that's cool for me. But I'm cold. I'm even cold right now, but I don't like to wear clothes. So that part, I just need to be somewhere hot. And so all the people that are doing a raw journey, most of them relocate to tropical places because that's where the abundance of fruits and vegetables are, fruits specifically. Like I'm learning that in this way of living, that there are some things that I've categorized as vegetables that are actually fruits, like peppers, zucchini, cucumber. But zucchini and cucumber are in the melon family. Had no idea until I started this raw vegan journey, learning every day. So I say all that to say that this diet or this way of living could be most optimal. I should say, not could be, certainly would be most optimal to be most successful in if you lived in a space where you could get fruits and vegetables in abundance. But here in the States, where it's a high fluctuation of temperature and not as consistent, thanks global warming, then it's not the most optimal here. I just went to look. I was obsessed with rambutans for a second there, and I went and looked in the grocery stores. Can't find them anywhere. And my heart is ripping out of my chest because that had become my breakfast. I was eating, to break my fast, I was eating like two types of fruit and this apricot chia no raw mixture that I made, which if you want the recipe, then I'll be able to share the recipe in another video. But it was so good. I was like, this is perfect. Oh, with a tall glass of lemon water, because there's the detox part, with a lemon or lime detoxing your body. And yeah, it's just been overall just amazing, and I am excited for the future, and I'll be excited to share more about my raw vegan journey. Peace and blessings to all of you, and thank you for listening to my video and visiting my website and following me on social media. It's greatly appreciated, and thank you for it's an honor for me to be able to share my thoughts with you. So, peace and blessings. Have a fabulous, fabulous day, night, whatever part of the day you're viewing this. Take care.